Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel VAT the Base Mechanical Engineering. In this video, I explain you the multi-evaporator VCRS system with same temperatures and single compressors. And I also explain how to draw schematic diagrams step by step, individual components, how to draw its pH diagram and how to find out the equation of COP. Now we move towards our first step. Before that, I explain you what is meaning of multi-evaporator. Multi-evaporator means more than one evaporator is used, and this here is the same temperature, so it is a multi-evaporator, means it is installed at the different places but temperature is same. The multi-evaporator system is generally used for different cold storage and in dairy, where they are requiring the to maintain the different temperatures. For we talking about the dairy, it's required to store of the butter, milk, for drinking water, they are required different temperatures. At that time, multi-evaporator system is used. But in this video, I explain you at the for same temperatures. So first, we draw the first process for the multi-evaporator, same temperature with single compressor and expansion valve. So first, we starting from the compressor. So in the compressor, process 1 to 2 is takes place. Process 1 to 2 is isentropic compression process. Isentropic means at constant entropy, the pressure and temperature of the refrigerant is increased. Now we draw 1 to 2 process on the pH diagram. On the y-axis it is the pressure, on the x-axis it is the enthalpy, and this is the saturation curve. If you want to know the basic of pH diagram, then the link is provided on the top right screen of your mobiles, or where it is a I symbol, from where you can watch the video of pH diagram. This is the critical point. From the critical point left side it is a liquid line, and from the right side this is the vapor line. Okay, so first we put the point number one. The point number one is the saturated vapor and the low pressure. So point number one is coming to the bottom region and on the vapor line. So we putting the point number one here. And point number two, that is the pressure is increased, means point two is coming to the upper directions. Temperature is increased, that's why enthalpy is also increased. But entropy is remains constant, and the pH diagram, constant entropy line is drawn as the curve line. Like this way. So it is our point number two. Then this high pressure vapor refrigerants is supplied into the condensers. Condenser is one type of heat exchangers in which the heat is rejected by using the fan. Okay, so 2 to 3 processes. Isobaric heat rejection process. Isobaric means constant pressure. In that, the temperature is also remains constant, but its phase is changed. At the inlet of the condenser it is vapor phase, and outlet of the condenser it is liquid phase. So from the point number two, from which side we draw the third point? So it is a constant pressure, means horizontal line. So horizontal line is either drawn left side or right sides, but we know that it is the liquid line. So point number three is come on this liquid line and constant vapor. So from point number two we draw the horizontal line up to this point. So it is the three, and the mass in the condenser is the m, that is the mass of refrigerant circulated in the compressor and the condensers. Then this high pressure liquid refrigerant is supplied into the expansion valve. In the expansion valve, the process 3 to 4 is takes place. So 3 is the high pressure, 4 is the low pressure. So in the expansion valve, expansion of the refrigerant is takes place. When the expansion is takes place, this process is known as the isenthalpic expansion process. Isenthalpic means entropy is remains constant, means at the enthalpy, at the entry of expansion valve and at the outlet of expansion valve is same, means A3 is equal to H4, and the enthalpy is mentioned on the x-axis. So we draw the vertical line from that point 3. The vertical line is drawn in which direction? Upper or downward? So it is known as the drawn in the downward directions, because pressure is reduced. So here the high pressure, and when we move towards downward side is the pressure is reduced than lower sides. So here we check that when we take the projection of 3 to 4 point line on the x-axis, then A3 is equal to H4. So it is the same. Then at the point number 4, what is the state of the refrigerant? So it is the low pressure. low temperatures and vapor refrigerants, sorry, liquid refrigerants. Then it is supplied into the evaporator 1. So in the evaporator, sorry, in evaporator 2, in the evaporator 2, we supplying the mass m2 out of m mass. So m1 is the, m is summation of the m1 plus m2. Out of m, we supplied the m2 mass in the evaporator 2. Okay, so evaporator is also one type of heat exchangers. And in these evaporators, the process 4 to 1 is takes place. So evaporator is heat exchanger, that means at the constant pressure they absorb the heat from the space or a room from where we require to do the cooling. Okay, so condenser and evaporator are the heat exchangers. Condenser is reject heat to the atmosphere, evaporator are absorbed to heat from the room or space. So when the refrigerant is absorbed this heat, it start to convert into the vapor from the liquid state, but its temperature remains same, that means latent heat is absorbed. So point number 4 is in the wet vapor regions. From the point number 4, it start to absorb the heat, then its phase is converted into the vapor state. So we connect the 4 to 1 line and its mass is m1. Now we are studying the same temperatures. Okay, so in the pH diagram, same temperature line is drawn vertical on the liquid line, then after horizontal in wet region line, means in this region it is a horizontal line. Then after it is moving downwards, so it is a same line. Then how many evaporator is, suppose that is a 3, 4, 5 is used, then one, only one single line is come for all evaporators. Now then after we install the evaporator 1, in the evaporator 1 m1 mass of the refrigerant is supplied. Now what is the m? M is equal to m1 plus m2. So m1 mass of refrigerant is supplied into the evaporator 1. And evaporator 1 is also one type of heat exchanger, process takes place 4 to 1. So it's the same temperature, then that's why we give the same numbers. Okay, and same temperature also, so it is drawn as the only one line. And it's absorbed the heat, then its phase is converted into the vapor. So we are again coming to the same line, because the constant temperature line is drawn horizontals in this wet region. So same line is come for all the evaporators. So it is mass is the m1. Okay, so it's the schematic diagrams and pH diagram is drawn for the systems. Next we find out the equations for the COP. Okay, now this schematic diagram we use for the reference. Now what is m1? M1 is mass of the refrigerant circulated in evaporator 1, m2 is mass of refrigerant circulated in evaporator 2, and m is equal to summation of m1 plus m2. So when you solve the examples, the capacity of the evaporator is given, refrigerating effect is given, its temperature is given, condenser pressure or temperature is given. From that you draw the pH diagram that we already discussed. Okay, so this type of the pH diagram you draw on the whatever the refrigerant is given, R12 is given, then draw this type of diagram on the R12 and find out the enthalpy. From the point number 1, draw vertical line, read the value of HO enthalpy. From point number 2, draw the vertical line here and read the enthalpy. Similarly, we read all the point enthalpy. Then find out the m1, m2, power supplied to the compressors and the COP. So first we find out the m1. So finding out the m1, we require the refrigerating effect RE1 and RE2, that is already given in example. So refrigerating effect RE1 is equal to, so refrigerating effect 1 is produced inside the evaporator 1. So in the evaporator 1, what is the value of mass? That is the m1. And in bracket, difference of enthalpy, that is h1 minus h4. Okay, so for writing this equation, it is simple. Only just write the what's the mass circulated inside and change in the enthalpy. Okay, so there's the evaporator, this enthalpy minus this. So you write down the that. Next, we find out the mass m2. So RE2 is equal to m2 h1 minus h2. So in evaporator 2, mass is m2, this is the h1 minus h4. That's why we find out the mass m2. And next we find out the work done. Work done or power supplied to compressor, it is denoted W or P. So here what is the mass in the compressor? So in the compressor, mass is the m, and m is the summation of the mass m1 and m2. So whatever the mass coming out from evaporator 1 is m1, mass coming out from evaporator 2 is m2, that is mixed here and supplied it at the in the compressors. So equation is equal to m into h2 minus h1, and this m is equal to summation of m1 plus m2. Then find out the COP. COP is equal to refrigerating effect upon work done. In the refrigerating effect, we have the two evaporator. So we do the summation of the refrigerating effect 1 plus refrigerating effect 2. Whatever the value is come, put here, divided by work done. This is the equation of work done. Find the value of work done and put in this equation, and you are able to find out the value of COP. Thank you for watching this video. If you learned something, then subscribe my channel for watching more video and share with your friends.